Welcome to this quick guide where I'm going to show you how to fix or troubleshoot any issues you might be having with Bluetooth in Windows 10 and Windows 11. And if you get any value out of this video, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. But to get started with the guide, if you want to fix or troubleshoot Bluetooth issues in Windows 10 and Windows 11, the first thing we need to check is that you have the correct drivers installed for your Bluetooth device. Now to do that, whether you're using Windows 10 or Windows 11, you can right-click on your Start button. Then you can click on Device Manager. Now here in the Device Manager, click on View and then click on Show Hidden Devices. And then you need to check if you have a Bluetooth section here. If you double click on that, and it's going to expand all of the Bluetooth drivers that you have installed on your system. Now if you don't see a Bluetooth tab here, it means you don't have any Bluetooth drivers installed on your system. And most likely you'll also have some devices here that are without drivers, and they'll have these yellow exclamation marks next to them. But to make sure that you have the correct driver and the latest driver installed for your Bluetooth device, we can just minimize the Device Manager, and then you can open any browser on your computer, and then go to the Snappy Driver Installer Origin webpage by Glenn Delahoy. This program is going to help us install or update our Bluetooth drivers, and you need to make sure that you're getting it from this webpage, the correct webpage, because there are other versions of this app which might come bundled with malware or adware, so you need to make sure that you're getting it from this webpage. But once you're on this webpage, you can scroll down and then you can click on the Download Now button. On the next page, you can also scroll down until you get to this Download Application section, and then you can just click on the Snappy Driver Installer Origin file to download it. It's going to download it in a zip file, and you can click on the folder so you can show it in your Downloads folder. And then you'll need to extract this file, so you can right-click on it. Then you can click on the Extract All option. But if you have software like WinRAR or 7-Zip installed, you can also use that to extract these files. But you have to extract it. So I'll click on Extract All, then click on Extract. So it's going to extract it to a new folder inside of my Downloads folder. And then in this new folder, you'll find some files. And the one that you're looking for is this SDIO application. And you can just double click on that to launch the Snappy Driver Installer Origin application. This is the first screen that you'll see, and you'll need to accept the terms. And then next, you'll see this welcome screen. Now here you need to select the third option to download indexes only. Click on that, and then you can click on this button up here. Make sure that indexes are selected and click on this PC only. Then click on accept and OK. And then it's going to download an index of all the drivers you have installed on your system. Now as you can see here, for me it's detected that on this computer I have a Realtek Bluetooth 4.0 adapter. And right now the driver is available, but it's not installed yet. So to install it, you can just select this checkbox and then you can click on Install. And if you hover your mouse over here on this ribbon, you'll see the status of that driver, whether it's downloading and installing. And right now you can see that there's about 10 minutes remaining for the installation of this driver. So just wait for the driver to download and install, and then we can carry on with the guide. So once it's finished downloading, it's going to extract that driver, and then it's going to install it on your system. And then once it's installed, you'll see that it's installed successfully, but right now I have to restart my computer for the installation to complete. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on this ribbon up here to restart the system, and then just click on the Start button, then click on Power, and then click on Restart. So my computer is just finished restarting now, and if I right-click on the Start button, then go to Device Manager, and then expand this Bluetooth again, I can see that I've got the correct Bluetooth driver installed now, because all of these devices are installed, and they don't have any yellow exclamation marks. And just to double-check, if I go back to my Downloads folder, and I run the Snappy Driver Installer Origin application again, click on accept, I can now see that all of my drivers are up to date, including the Bluetooth driver. So I'll just exit out of this, and now let's test if we can connect the device via Bluetooth to the computer. So to do that, just do a search for Bluetooth. You should get this Bluetooth and other devices settings best match. Just click on that. It's going to open the settings, and then you'll see whether Bluetooth is turned on. So make sure that it is turned on by clicking on this slider. I've just turned it off, so just make sure that it is turned on by clicking on the slider. Once it's turned on, you can connect a new device to your computer. You can click on Add Device. Then next, you'll need to choose the kind of device that you want to add. Now, we want to add a Bluetooth device, so just select Bluetooth. It's going to do a scan for all of the Bluetooth devices that are discoverable in your area. Now, for me, I'm trying to connect my smartphone, which is this Redmi Note 11 Pro. So to connect it, you can just click on it. Just select the device that you want to connect. If you do need a pin, you can just check that the pin on the computer and the pin on the device that you're trying to connect matches. Then once it does match, you can just click on pair and connect. And then you'll see this message that your device is ready to go. And in my case, my smartphone is now connected to the laptop via Bluetooth. Now, just to show you another example, I'm going to connect a Bluetooth speaker to the laptop. And to do that, I'm just going to switch on the Bluetooth speaker. And you'll hear it make a sound when it's turned on. You can click on Add Device, click on Bluetooth. Again, it's going to do a search for all of the available Bluetooth devices in the area. And there you can see that the Bluetooth speaker, which is an audio device, is now discovered by my laptop. So just click on that to connect it. And in this case, I didn't need to enter any pin. It just automatically connected to that Bluetooth device. So it's ready to go. Just click on done. And if I go ahead and I just do a sound test, the sound is now being played through that Bluetooth speaker. So I'm just going to turn off that Bluetooth speaker, which will also then automatically disconnect it. As you can see here from the audio devices, it's now disconnected because it's turned off. So that's how you can connect Bluetooth devices. And if you're still having any other issues, you can just scroll down and you should also see more Bluetooth settings here. And you can click on that and you can just have a look through all of these options. For example, you can allow Bluetooth devices to find this PC. And you also have some control over the notifications. And then here you also have this option to show the Bluetooth icon in the notification area. So what that means is on Windows 11, if you click on these icons here, you'll find this Bluetooth icon here in the notification tray. On Windows 10, you might have to click on the notification bar in the right corner. And then at the bottom here, you'll see a Bluetooth option that you can select. But that's basically it for the Bluetooth settings. Then you can just click on Apply and OK. And if you want to send or receive files via Bluetooth, you can just click on this option. And then you can choose if you either want to send or receive files. Now, I'm not going to be showing that in this video. And on Windows 10, if you can't find this option, you can also just click on the system tray. And then you can find the Bluetooth icon here. And if you right click on that icon, you'll also find some options where you can send a file or receive a file. And you also have some other Bluetooth settings here. Now, if you followed all of these steps and you still couldn't get the Bluetooth to work on your laptop or computer, what I recommend you do in that case is that you just get a USB dongle, because most likely there's something wrong with either the Bluetooth device in your laptop or computer, or there's just something wrong with the drivers. I've spent days on troubleshooting Bluetooth issues on laptops, even on new laptops, where the drivers are installed correctly and according to Windows, everything should be working fine. But I just couldn't get any devices to connect to the laptop or computer. And the simplest way just to fix that is to just buy a cheap USB Bluetooth dongle, connect that to the computer. It's most probably going to have its own plug and play drivers. So you don't even need to go online and find additional drivers and then try and test your Bluetooth again by using that USB Bluetooth dongle. But this has been my guide on how to fix or troubleshoot any Bluetooth issues you might be having on your computer. And I hope this guide's been useful. Please like the video and I'll talk to you guys soon.